shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. And if
my name's Thomas Kearns-Phillips, and I am the writer of the short film The Warden, which is a film based during the Blitz of 1940, during the Second World War, and is centred around Arthur, a man who wants to join the army to go and fight on the continent, but is denied due to medical reasons. He has a heart murmur. So he instead joins the Civil Defence Service and becomes an air raid warden. The film is really centred around Arthur's personal traumatic experiences. He sees young men that he knows enlisting to go and fight, and he has a sense of guilt about that because he can't do that. His family is evacuated, he sends them away to keep them safe, so he's alone. And the film really deals with Arthur's sense of futility, that even though he's an air raid warden and he's trying to help people, there's sometimes nothing he can do to stop the damage and the carnage that's been wrought by the bombings. I've been developing The Warden as a short film for a few years now. It's largely inspired by my great-grandfather, who was an air raid warden. I've often wondered, what sort of things did he experience? What sort of things did he see? And how did he cope with those things emotionally? My grandmother has always told me that he hardly ever spoke about his experiences. And that always made me wonder, you know, what did he see that made him not want to talk about it? What made him not want to recount those events? Although the film is a dramatised account of the Blitz, I believe it fills a niche in the period drama slash war genre. An air raid warden has never really been the protagonist. They've never really been the focus of a story. They've been in the background, they've been there doing their job, but they've never been the one that we follow. The reason I'm using Crowdfunder for this project is because I want to be able to use locations and costumes that are as authentic as possible. I really want to give the film that sense of realism and believability. And there are locations that I've found that really lend themselves to that. I'm also using crowdfunding because I really believe in community involvement, whether that's the local area where I intend to shoot and where I intend to hire, Stockport Garrick Theatre, Stockport Air Raid Shelter, the East Lancs Railway, they're all very local, as well as the online community where it's possible to reach anyone in the world who has an interest in helping to tell stories. And essentially that's what I want to do, I want to tell a story. So lastly, I hope that your interest has been piqued and that you decide to support The Warden. Thank you.